Meet the freshwater mussel. There's 51 different types of them here in Minnesota. And many of the river's mussels we no longer find. To quote Bernard Seitman, a malacologist on the history of America's mussels.
And there are historical accounts where they said you could walk miles of a river and never set foot without stepping, without treading, I think you, without treading on a live mussel. They were that abundant and widespread.
North America has had at least 30 freshwater mussel species go extinct. So what's happening to them? Where are they going? The primary cause is human activity. We're allowing their environment to be degraded through pollution, damming, and creating irrigations. We're choking them out through overfishing and boat traffic. Not only that, we've introduced invasive species to our waters, which are outcompeting our native freshwater mussel. Most notably is another mussel species, the zebra mussel. And why does this matter? Mussels are filter feeders, which keep the water of our rivers, lakes, and ponds clean. They are a common food source among many water and land creatures, and their filtering provides a food source for aquatic plants and microorganisms.
Those components are packaged together in pseudo-feces, and that stuff is eaten by stuff.
You see, mussels are a keystone species. They provide habitat, food, and life. Without them, the water ecosystems will quickly begin to collapse. They can go from looking like this to this. And so, what can we do? Well, the most important thing to do is raise awareness. Many people don't even know freshwater and mussels exist, and it's a fascinating world that these creatures hold. Secondly, if you're taking equipment and boats into water, always clean your equipment before and after being in the water to reduce transference of invasive species. Especially be cautious when you're traveling in port waters like Lake Superior or the Mississippi River. It's good to know that in Minnesota, it's illegal to collect live mussels, and there's limits to how many may be collected with a fishing license. Check the DNR website for these regulations. We need to help protect our mussel friends, for the health of our homes depend on it. So please, read more about these fascinating creatures here on our Instagram page. Spread knowledge about the dying freshwater mussels of the Upper Mississippi. You can also watch the full interview with Bernard Seitman, as this video only covered a sliver of it. It will be linked in the description. Thank you for listening.